What's going on, everybody, and welcome to the Full Game Walkthrough Series, episode 37. And today, we are going to be doing the Mushroom Temple, otherwise known as the Shirataki. I was going to record this with Lewis, but, you know, it's getting a little later, and by the time this video renders, it's going to take suns. And I'm just going to do it solo. I was planning on recording it with him, but he is asleep currently, from what I imagine. I feel like his sleep schedule is off track, so come on, Lou, let's get going. and there's some people that I wanted to do with me, but I believe I can manage it. Shirataki Temple is one of those where it, if you have previously done it on a different character, I believe, you can just activate this, or maybe, can we just go through it?
Perhaps there is a key up the road that
lever,
will unlock
or no, maybe there's a key, or maybe you have to do it on all characters. Let me just try and do the lever though one last time in case. Nope.
Perhaps there is a key.
Okay, thank you. Perhaps there's a key. Yes, okay, a key. So I thought you could just do it, you know, without getting a key if you've already done it on one character, but they might have changed that, which is fine. We just have to defeat a boss. I'm wearing my life mastery amulet. I put in a few heals. I've also had some questions regarding Seder, and when I'll be spending my points. I believe I have to have 7 points to get Seder, so I'll be doing that very soon.
You seek a way through that gate? Forget your quest, wizard. Here you will only feel the sting of a Ronin blade.
Okay, Ronin blade. Balance and balance, huh? Alright. I also took the TCs out of my old deck, so I did not discard that. I almost did, though. I think one heal will be fine, sufficient enough. My pet should be able to heal, I hope, and I don't think these guys will be that bad. I want to try out Minotaur on the final boss in here. That'd be really exciting. Okay. 1700 health, alright. It's actually quite a bit. We got double power pip, which is really good here. Bum 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 bum. I really like my new gear. I like the previous one as well. I have like 41 Resil against Myth. That's just the way the gear goes. It's actually kind of funny. Thank you. What a bro. Let me like say thank you to him. Thank you. Alright, what are we going to do? We are going to... We're going to discard Minotaur for now. Because we have an extra one. We're going to discard that. We're going to Myth Trap. No, we're going to time a legend. Yeah, we're going to time a legend. And then we'll do double traps. And we have more damage this time. Barely. I mean, I think we have like an extra, what, 2 or 3 or so? Which is really good. Minus 45. I expected that, actually. I expected that, definitely. So we're going to remove that. We are going to shield. Alright. We're going to use that just in case. If I do fizzle, I'll use it on something that... I think I will fizzle here. Oh, no! Hey, that's actually really good, though, too. Tower shields, like I said, a long time ago, I believe it was back in... What was I in? Krakatopia? I think it was at the very end of Wizard City is when I got Tower Shield. Or... I'll have to look back at the walkthrough. So basically, Tower Shield is very essential. Very essential. I also have a Spirit Blade. I put one in, or maybe two. I think I put one in. Should probably put in more than one, though. So that it shows up more often. The most likely use a weakness or something soon. Hopefully not, though. We'll have to see. Every time I see Snowman now, I always think of the Woolly Mammoth. But when the Woolly Mammoth, or... yeah, I think that's what it's called for sure. Whenever it's summoned, it... you know what? I feel like... No, we're not going to use it in here. Whenever it's summoned, it's knocks over the snowman. That's funny. Okay, well, you know what? We're going to kill the mob, and then we'll set up to kill the boss. I feel like we just need to get rid of at least one, which you probably should have done a little, maybe a turn earlier or so. I think we're still in good terms. This will do about like 800 or so. Maybe even 1,000 if I boost. Yeah, boost. 1,500? Oh my gosh. Am I that powerful now against balance? I guess the gear upgrade maybe did help out. Might be the pouch robe that I'm wearing for good luck. Yeah, he is dead. That's amazing. All right, let's use troll. We still have the aura. Maybe it's the aura. Maybe I should use the aura more often. But it's only plus 25, though. So it's not that big a difference. Kind of. Up for debate. So this is no enchant. That's really good. So how much damage do we have?
You have gotten the key from him.
Well, thank you. Shoes of dreaming. I'm about to pass. No, not really. 27 damage. Never realized I actually have that much. I'm oblivious to my own power. Kind of. Oh yeah, and also I have the Koi mount. I decided to switch to that for the remainder of Mushu to change things up a bit. I like the Koi mount. It's always happy. It's a fish. Do fishes have emotions? Do fish have emotions? Question of the day. I wonder if they do. I think I read something one time that they have like an attention span of like 5 seconds or something like that, and then they forget everything. I don't know. That would kind of suck, wouldn't it? Meet people 5 seconds later. I think some people do actually have that, like the brain damage and whatnot. That's crazy. Heart goes out to those people. Okay, what do we have to do here? We have to like deactivate this, or is that all we have to do? Well, that was simple enough. I wish there was a brazier in front of the other one. Oh my gosh. Alright, let's go talk to Din Ho. I believe after we defeat, I think the final boss, can't remember, is back in that little, like, village to the left that you see in the bottom corner, or it's behind the cave. This is actually a really cool place. I mean, they went all out on this dungeon, I feel. The Mushroom Temple. Shirataki Mushrooms? Yes. Which I don't think they were going for the Mushroom Temple, but I'll call it that. I really do like this cave. I mean, you look at it, it's actually really beautiful, is it not? Oh yeah, these, oh my. A thing to note, do not get pulled by these brutes. This is actually going to be a little bit tricky, because their pull rate is one of the highest in like all of Mushu from what I remember, which is not a good thing. I'm just going to YOLO it, actually, because I feel if I don't there, then I would never get past. And I really like these like stone archways with like the pigs. I wonder if those are actually housing items that are in the bazaar. I've never actually seen anything like that, but it's a possibility. Look at that temple. That's really cool. I really like that. All right, let's talk to Din Ho and see what we have to do.
You'll find the plague only in the palace beyond this gate. You must hurry. It is weakened now. I can hear it wailing in distress. If you succeed, find Sun Hing. May the Muda look after you.
Praise be.
Oh. We will now purify the water. The temple ahead of you is where you must go.
Okay.
But first, we must dispatch Haru. He holds the gate key. Defeat Haru and open the temple gate.
Okay. Also, if you are a little bit forward to where I am right now while you talk to Din Ho, you'll get pulled. So, I almost actually did. You need to be careful with that one. My gosh, this is amazing. I really like this area. Are we safe to go by? Possibly. Safe to go by? Is he seriously going all the way down that ramp? Come on now, diseased water spirit. Oh, we're going. We should leave a mark here. Did I leave a mark here? Can we leave a mark in here or no? Oh yeah, there we go. Must not have clicked it. Are we going to make it? Oh my gosh, there's just too many close corners in this area. But Mushu is famous for them, definitely. Okay, we're going to go over here. I wonder how they planted that tree over there. Maybe it was just the Muda himself. It's an amazing water area. I think there's like actually a Mushu house. I think the Mushu house actually has like a garden water thing similar to that. I've always wanted to like add water features to a home. I know like fountains kind of count, but I feel like if you could actually add natural water to different areas or make like ponds or something, that'd be really cool. Or even a waterfall. I think waterfalls would be awesome. And most homes actually have some type of water feature, so I really can't complain. That's an interesting banner. Little koi pond as well. Similar to the Crimson Fields area, as you remember. We should be okay on mana. I don't think we're going to have to worry about that much. Alright, Haru Myth. Okay. Now we're having a little bit of a challenge here, but I think we'll still be fine. Let's actually put in some extras here so we can get it right off the bat. And we'll get some pierces in. Maybe an extra heal. Actually, instead of an extra heal... Yeah, I think we should put an extra heal. No, we're going to go with the shield. Let's go with the shield. Okay, I think we're ready to go, everybody.
So you need a key to get through the
gate. You'll never take mine.
You'll never take mine. Okay.
Well, I am going to take it, Haru. So, rest in peace, my brother. He lives in such a, like, a depressing area. It's kind of sad. And we went first. This is so good. So good. I probably should have kept that prism, but you know what? Is what it is. I feel like if I have my aura and then two blades from the spirit and the normal, I should be able to kill Haru. That'd be really good. We're gonna Myth Blade. Hopefully Time of Legend pops. Starting to realize Time of Legend is actually really good. Two pips, but if you have the power pips, like I said earlier, it's power pip percentage chance, it seems like, for Myth is pretty important. For Humunga Frog, I mean, yeah, so you can go really fast, but I feel like in the beginning stages throughout the entire time, it seems like for Myth, power pips are more essential than from what I realized from Death. You know, because I've had my Death character for forever, right? And I feel like, well, what should we do here? Let's remove the Pierce, and then let's Myth Trap. And you know what? We might even hit next. We might. And from what I've seen, I mean, since I've had my Death for, what, 4 years now or so or more? Maybe even more. Anyway, I feel like power pips are essential for every class, but for Myth and maybe even Storm, power pips are pretty huge. I might be completely wrong, but from my own personal experiences, because I've only had experiences with Myth so far, you know, and Death, and then I have a Storm character, but the Storm character, I don't really know if I'm going to be leveling it anytime soon. More likely to level my Death for Legendary PvP, which I plan to do this week. You know, we're just going to hit. That's what we're going to do. We're going to hit and pray. I feel like with the boost in one blade, at least over 1,000, I'll Prism again, and then I'll use Troll. Or if I have enough... Oh, of course, Fizzle. Cyrus, where are you when I need you? He'd probably say something sarcastic like he always does, but I feel like Cyrus is... He comes off, like, at the very beginning, from what I've always, like, kind of stated, as, I don't know, rude... But I feel like that's, like, his nature, because he is, like, a lot of story and, like, kind of hatred, kind of. I don't know. I get that vibe from him. But then he turns around to be a really great person, so I don't know. It's a toss-up. But, yeah, previously, before I actually knew how he was when I was reading comments back in Wizard City, I thought he was, like... one of the worst teachers, but I've come around to enjoy his sarcasm. Woo, like, on like a scale between Woo and Cyrus, I mean, yeah, Woo takes the cake. It's not even a question. It did 1,200. Oh my gosh. Slaying. Minus, thank you, Haru. Now, see, I have a Pierce for that one reason. We're going to Pierce, and then we're going to Prism, and then Troll. He should be dead. So not too bad. Not too bad at all. There we go. Oh, and also, if you haven't noticed as well, people were mentioning my Lightning Bolt staff. I stitched it to the Sky Iron Hasta. So... have that damage. So yeah, I am definitely taking advantage of this Sky Iron Hasta, which I recommend everybody using. If you can get a group in Mount Olympus, definitely. It is so worth it. It's honestly one of the best up until... Like, I can't even remember. I know there's like a few crowns, staffs, or wands that are really good higher up, but I feel like... Well, definitely when you get to Celestia and Zephyria for the crit and whatnot. Crit block, for that matter. Alright, he's dead. Rest in peace, Haru. Unless I fizzle. Never mind. I actually have 8 accuracy, which is really good. I don't remember Death Gear giving this much accuracy back then, but maybe they changed it. Or maybe I was just oblivious as well. I've been oblivious to a lot of things lately, but it all ends good. Alright, let's go open the gate. What did we get? Shoes of Woe. That's actually really cool. Oh my gosh. Somebody tweeted at me. I think it was Intoxicated Cat. Shout out to you. Tweeted at me and Lewis. There was, I think it was like a robe or boots of Vexing. It's amazing. It's like the best thing I've ever seen. 1800 XP. Oh my. Did you see how close that got? Okay, I'm going. I'm hiding. Dinho, save me. I'm hiding behind this, like, what is this? Yeah, statue.
Now to summon Wavebringer. This water spirit guards the entrance to the river temple. Use the jade scepter on the 4 shrines to summon Wavebringer.
Okay, we're gonna use one potion because I feel like kind of OCD about the mana. Kind of. Use the fire shrine. Okay, I'm gonna go. Well, actually, I think we can. Well, okay. I don't know if we have to do a battle or not. These diseased water spirits, though. But I'm going to cut to when I get all the shrines. If I have to fight somebody, then I'll just cut to there. If not, I'll just cut to back when I'm back at Dinho. So I'll see you guys then. Alrighty, welcome back, everybody. So, let me just go over the shrines real quick. I mean, the last one, the Air Shrine. Every other shrine had mobs in them. The Earth Shrine had 2 storm minions. Fire had a myth and storm. Spirit had myth and balance. So basically a lot of myth. So watch out for those. The final shrine, Zaneki, who is fire, and then minion balance. So after we do all these shrines, we will be able to summon the water? Get him good or something up there? Can't remember what Dinho said. So let's start trapping him. Hopefully we can find Time of Legend relatively soon. So basically the shrines weren't that bad. Pretty far away, so yeah, leave a mark by Dinho. And not in the middle of the street because you will get pulled by those infected water elementals, which are a pain. They really are. So watch out for those. I'm gonna blade up, get rid of the weakness, and then make our way. There's still a little bit more to do in the Mushroom Temple. We have to summon that boss in the middle, and then, well, not in the middle of the water, but behind Dinho, and then go inside the actual cave, and then there's a little bit of backstory from what I remember. Alright, so let's get rid of this weakness. Hopefully we can find Time of Legend or my Spirit Blade. Pretty sure I still have a Spirit Blade, and I changed my deck up a little bit when fighting the minions. I find it actually easier to have a smaller amount of cards when you go against minions, like 2 Hunger Frogs, maybe a few blades, and then, especially going against, you know, Myth, you have to have the Pierce and Traps. Pierce is such a great card, it really is, especially when you are, throughout the entire game for Myth to get rid of shields and whatnot, it's a great card. Alright, let's use Time of Legend. So happy we actually got it. I was afraid we weren't gonna get it. At least we did get it. Plus 25, and I am going to hit then. Unless I can find another boost, which is not my luck. Nope, couldn't find a boost. Alright, we are gonna Humongous Frog. We should actually... Hopefully we can find Troll. I think I still have Troll in. I might have completely spaced on fixing my deck up. Which won't be good, but it's fine. We still have enough pips to Humongous Frog again if we need to. Which I don't think this will kill. Maybe, though. Maybe. If our luck is good. 1100, I'm liking that. 1300-ish, possibly kill. Nope. Oh, 1300 almost. Hey, there you are. Almost. Oh, now Spirit Blade pops. Well, he's dead anyway. 252, yep, he's dead. No need in wasting a Monstrous. That's why I love this new deck as well. You can put so many Monstrous in so you can... Oh, Fizzle. Of course. Never mind. So you can forget to actually put more TC in, and you should be okay for a while. A Fire... This is the most powerful attack I've seen, literally, in Mushu so far. I mean, this is going to do mass. If 546. That was probably one of the biggest hits we've had in all of Mushu. Seriously. And I'm a little bit worried, though, too, about the cave. I don't think I'm going to use my potion. I'm going to save my potion before we go inside the actual lair. I think it's a lair. Isn't it a lair? Yeah, it's a lair. What am I thinking? Okay, use the... Oh, yeah, I got to use the shrine. Can't forget that. All right, defeat Wavebringer, which is where? He must be farther away than that. He has to be, right? Let's go outside and see. He has to be. Yeah, 600 away. A Wavebringer. Okay, so that's what his name is. Let's get some health wisps. Wisps? That's a weird name to say. Weird word. Not a name. Let's go back to the... Let's go back to Dinho. See, look at that. Moss back. Where's he at? There he is. They're both Storm,
you
huh?
You will sleep soundly when I am done with you.
So he's gonna try and make me pass. Actually, not bad. Alright, let's put some two trolls in. I think we're good. Let's defeat this Wavebringer boss. Let's bring it. $1,900? That's a fair amount. That is a fair amount. I am going to Spirit Blade. And then hopefully find my Myth Blade. And then I'm hitting. I'm hitting right after I find my Myth Blade. The sooner I can hit before they have a chance to use their shields, the better. Saves a round. Saves a round I don't have to pierce. Every little bit helps. Definitely. Definitely helps. Trap is... it's not really sufficient. You know what? We're just going to use it. We're going to hit anyway, because we need to get rid of that mob. The mob is most important to get rid of right now. So we can just focus. Since they're both Storm, my worries are... Well, my biggest worry, I should say, is they both use Shark, but it looks like they don't have enough pips, either of them. So I'm going to try and hit before they can actually use or even have enough pips to use Shark. Because Shark... Storm Shark is actually really good. You know what? I'm going to time a legend. No, I'm not going to push my luck. I'm not pushing my luck. That is terrible luck. I do have terrible luck. Just the way it goes. And when you don't want to fizzle, I think that's for every school as well. When you don't want to fizzle, you fizzle. And then your mind is just like, the game knows. The game really does know. Half the time, anyway. How much did that do? Four. See? That's a fair amount. It's a fair amount. One trap. One blade is pretty good. Really good. Okay. So we are going to troll and hopefully not fizzle for the third time in a row. I'm telling you. I actually like that statue. That's actually really cool. Statues of Mushu are unique, to say the least. Right, what did we get? Nothing really good. Oh, defeat Plagoni. Is he on our side now? Wood chest. All right, let's use his potion. Using the potion. How much is this going to give? 79. It's not bad. I have no clue where we're going, but we're going in.
Breaking your spirit will give me more pleasure than breaking your wand.
This is probably the coolest place in all of Mushu to have a boss battle. It is really amazing. I really think this is cool. One of the more beautiful places to have a boss battle. Alright, Ideyoshi. So basically, after you defeat Ideyoshi, he then transforms into the plague. So it's a transformation fight. Well, double fight, basically. Alright, it's time of legend. Really good fight. This is one of the... I think, honestly, this is probably... the best place, if not top three, in Mushu to fight a boss. It's just amazing. The atmosphere is awesome. You have, like, flowing water right here. You have organics up above. It's really awesome. Alright, let's remove this. Hopefully we can find a wand hit soon. Hopefully. If that, then a myth blade would be really, really good as well. Minus 45. It seems like the balance bosses are really good. Or not balance. Ice or balance are actually really pretty good. We are going to YOLO Myth Trap. We're going to YOLO Myth Trap. Most likely will fizzle. Most likely. Yep. Did fizzle. Should have used the shield. I think I might even just hit now. Well, oh yeah, I think I might just hit now. Because I want to get a little bit of damage on him, and then I also want to kill that minion. Because he has a lot of pips, and that's not good at all. So I'm just going to Humongo Frog now, since I have the aura up. If I didn't have the aura up, I would not have. But I'm pretty sure we can kill the minion. With the boost. With the boost, I believe. 700? Yep, he's definitely dead now. So I would say like 800-900 or so. Almost 1,000, that's pretty good. It's really good. Alright, so he's not below 1,000, which is... We're kind of in an okay position. We're just going to Myth Trap, Blade, and then hopefully find a Troll, and he's dead. If we draw a Troll in the next two rounds, we're in a good spot. And hopefully after he hits me a couple of times, my pet heals, so I can be at relatively okay health. I wonder if there's actually health wisps around here somewhere. Wisps. See, I can't say just wisps because I don't know. I guess that's just the way I am. My S's are very pronounced, kind of. I don't think I've actually ever have I done over. I think I've done 1,000 damage before with a troll. Maybe back in Marley Bone. I've used troll a lot, not recently, but it is like one of the main things for Myth in the beginning. That and Cyclops. Cyclops is always a fun spell to use. 1,001, so he's almost dead. Almost. I thought I could have killed him, but I think the base was too low. Probably should have just used Humongo Frog, but it's okay. I was wanted. 1,100 health. Pet, wake up, plus. Alright, we are going to troll. I probably could have just used the wand hit and made sure 100% kill because since he's ice, but it's okay. We're still good. Alright, second form here.
Defeated, Ideyoshi crumples to the ground and fades. A demon emerges from his still form. It is the Plague Oni.
The Plague Oni, huh? Okay, so no health wisps. I should have saved that potion. I don't know, 1,100 health? Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna put a heal in, we're gonna put an extra shield in. We're gonna put two minions in. Myth Blade. He's Myth, we need traps, or prisms. I think we're gonna be okay. I think we're good. You know what? 1,100 health. I wonder if I... Can I just leave a port in here? Just leave a port in here. Hopefully it doesn't reset. If it resets, I'll just battle the guy again. But I need that health. The health is gonna... I just need it. And I think I can just go get a wisp. Hopefully. We're good? Okay, we're at full health. Alright, I'm going back in the actual temple. Is he still summoned? Hopefully he is. Yes, he is. Okay, confirmed. We're okay. We're gonna be so good. Oh, we're definitely gonna be really good. Oh, we're good. Plague Oni, bring it on. You're nothing, my brother. 2,200? You might be something now. And at least we went first. So now, no matter what they do, this prism... I'm just gonna take care of the minion right away. I am going to... Humongo Frog as soon as possible, which will be next, because Humongo Frog with one prism will kill these guys instantly. I'm just gonna get rid of the minion, not gonna worry about him. Most likely a waste of pips, but you know what? We're gonna do it anyway. Because what the heck? Yep, we are hitting. It will kill him for sure. I've done this many times. Never mind. Fizzle. Weakness? Thank you. Never mind. It wasn't even a weakness. Oh my gosh. Well, we're in a pickle. We don't need that anymore. We don't need that. You don't need that. Draw? Humunger Fog, possibly? Oh my gosh. Are we going to YOLO it? We're YOLOing it. Cyrus, be with us. I swear if I fizzle, I will deliver groceries. Oh my gosh. Oh my. Just like the one time we delivered the robes and like the dry cleaning to him and whatnot. At least my pet healed though. That's really good. Alrighty. Are we... Oh my gosh. No hit up. Draw. Humunger Fog plus. Plus. Well, that is a terrible hand. We are going to... Myth Minion. That is probably the worst hand I've ever had. The myth gods are not with me right now. Not at all. I'm not gonna die. There's no way. It's just a delay in the inevitable. Remove that. Humunger Frog. Thank you. Praise be. Pless die pig. Oh my word. We've made it. We did it. We have a minion on our side. This will most likely do 600 to 900. Yeah, almost 700. 900, what was I thinking? Rippin' pepperonis. That blade, that's really good. Yeah, this temple's actually not that bad. I thought it was gonna be a lot harder, but it's manageable. We're gonna remove that, remove that. It's gonna trap, I'm going to shield myself. Take a little less damage than what he's gonna do. Use next. There we go. Is that the 25 or 35? I think the 35 is only a amulet, which I'm not wearing right now. I'm wearing my life mastery because I was afraid that I'd need it, you know, in a desperate situation, but I think we're going to be all right. We're just both going to hit. If he's using Cyclops, I'll use Humunger Frog. With the blade and trap, he's most likely dead. Most likely. But, you know, bad things have happened before. And he's probably not going to be dead. How much will this do? If he does the most... I don't even know how much health he had. I should have looked. I think he had, like... still quite a bit. He is dead. Praise. Plagoni is dead. Soon Hing. Master Yan Khan Kook. What does he sell? Oh! Keeper of the Flame and everything else? No way. So he does all... Oh, he gives all of these ones. Ninja Pig? Amazing. But I'm pretty sure I can only craft after I've done Safaria crafting, so... That's amazing. Did they just put him here? They must have. Alright, let's go back to the Jade Palace, because we gotta talk to Soon Hing, which is in the... So basically, yeah, this is the last part of the village. Next part is the Yoshoshito Temple, with the Tree of Life, Ancient Burial Grounds. My least favorite part of that area is the Ancient Burial Grounds. I think we'll be able to be... I think we'll survive. I think we'll be fine. But definitely not one of my favorites in Mushu. The majority, my favorite parts... are that place I was just in, the Shirataki Temple, Cave of Solitude, and then I also really like the Tree of Life. I like the very end part, which I'm pretty sure the final boss of that drops an ultra rare thing, or I think it's a secret boss in there that does an housing item. It's really cool.
Wizard, we are most grateful to you for defeating the Plague Oni. Merciful Muda! I never thought that water would be pure again. I feel like I need a serious vacation. Who knew the life of a monk could be so stressful? Please bring this vial of pure water to the High Monk Tan King within the Jade Palace. As for me, I shall ponder my life's direction.
May the Muda be with you, Soon Hing. Alright, let's go back to To Tong Kang. I wonder why there's a dungeon recall. We already completed it. I guess that's what it does with every dungeon. So we purified the water in the village. It is a great day. So let's go talk to Tan Kang and then we'll wrap some things up here. Bum, 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 bum. And he's over to the left here. There he is. Alright, let's see what he has to say about this water.
Ah, a vial of pure water. It was a mistake to assume the waters would remain pure while His Imperial Majesty is ill. Thank you, Wizard. We have what we need to cure His Imperial Majesty's mind and spirit. But to heal his body, we will require fruit from the mystical tree of life. Just like the Oni possessed warlord Katsumori and polluted the waters of Mushu, the Death Oni has twisted the Tree of Life. Even with all my wisdom, I can't prepare you for what you will face. I urge you to speak with Samurai Hideo Kebo, a regarded
I'm not gonna
elder
pronounce
at
that right.
Temple. He will be able to guide you to the Tree of Life. May the Muda watch over you.
More like hide and seek. Okay, so next time we will be talking to Hide and Seek in the Yoshishito Temple. Leave a like if you've enjoyed today. A few hiccups near the end, some things happen, but, you know, we're good. So anyway, leave a like if you've enjoyed Yoshishito Temple on the horizon, and I'll see you guys next time. Enjoy the rest of your day.